alchemy in the Western medieval world had deep roots going back to late Roman Egypt, as well as numerous important thinkers from the medieval Islamic world. Alchemy was first practiced in the Latin West in the 12th century, a time that also saw the rise of universities and cities such as Siena, which you see here. It was in the 13th century, though, that a work came out attributed to Geber, named after one of his Islamic sources, that brought together key texts from Arabic and Persian alchemical tradition, as well as elements from the Aristotelian natural philosophy tradition, into a format that was accessible to his contemporaries, that is, a Latin scholastic summa. Latin was the language of scholarship and international communication at the time, and the summa format made the text more clear and comprehensible than the kind of abstract, poetic language often deployed. This compilation sparked more interest in alchemy in the medieval West, so other medieval alchemists began investigating matters such as how to create substances such as mineral acids, such as sulfuric acid. Even artists of the time came to appreciate some of the advances made by alchemists. By the 15th century, the writer and artist Cennino Cennini recommended that artists buy their artificial pigments, such as vermilion, from alchemists. You see some gorgeous vermilion used here in this painting by Titian to set off the robes of the Virgin. The medieval developments in alchemy set the stage for us better understanding the Ripley scrolls, which were made in the period following the Middle Ages, but are grounded in earlier alchemical thinking. The 23 existing Ripley scrolls are all made later, mostly in the 16th and 17th centuries, but take their name from their use of the alchemical verses found in the 15th century text by George Ripley. Ripley wrote The Compound of Alchemy, which he dedicated to King Edward IV in 1471. Ripley's work describes how to create the Philosopher's Stone. This stone was the ultimate prize for the alchemist, for it was reputed both to enable the transformation of other materials into gold or silver, and extend life or even convey immortality. Some of the processes that medieval alchemists used involved a special glass crucible, sometimes called the philosopher's egg or the vase of Hermes. The alchemist would take a common substance such as iron or copper and carefully heat it in the philosopher's egg, monitoring it for color changes. Alchemical texts describe a sequence of changes from black to white and finally red, which was the color it attained before its reputed transformation into gold. Please explore the full Ripley scroll on the Google Culture site so that you can see the fascinating range of its images.